speechless. I've got scars on my face, I got scars on my hand, I got scars from a woman, I got scars from a man. You see, y'all don't know this, you just don't understand. I've been painting over pictures I got on my trash can. You see, y'all don't know this, and you will see it's more to these rhythms, more than a melody. Nobody listened, but God heard me. It took 10 whole years to get everything that I dreamed. 10.5 reasons why.
All right, you guys know a lot of my subscribers do miss the vlog type videos, so this will be my vlog for the week. So I'm gonna take you guys on a shop with me, grocery haul, to Food Lion, and we're gonna see what type of deals we can get, what deals are already there, and what deals are specific for just for the MVP card. And make sure you guys get that, single moms, single parents, single dads, all y'all, make sure you get the MVP card. I don't think Walmart has anything other than really great discounts and better food options, just more food options, but let's get it, y'all. Let's go. This is the best way that I know how to save, especially when you go to the grocery store. Never go when you're hungry. Also, this is the Food Lion app, and it has your MVP special coupons, and right now my coupons are sitting at $21.75 worth of savings. And this is based off the stuff that I buy all the time. And so you can just go here and you can see all the things that have coupons. You got some cereal, Bounty, Yes Ma'am, baby food. You got more than just food. You got Tide. You got dog treats, tissue. Of course, I have a lot of baby items on mine because I buy a lot of that stuff. Laundry detergent, some more cleaning supplies. And all you do is click load to card and it'll pop up here on the My Coupons, which is in your MVP wallet. So when you swipe your MVP card or they scan your MVP card, these coupons come off when you, basically when you are about to, you know, pay when you're finished. And this is a great way to save money, and even though it's just a little bit, it means a whole lot, especially when you're going grocery shopping for the month.
And as you guys can see, I literally have to have a list. Like, I have to go with the list or else I will overspend. Go in and go out and walk at your mom pace, and don't stop talking to nobody or look too long, because if you look too long, you're gonna end up spending too much money because you're hungry.
All right, y'all, a lot of people really be asking me, like, how do you budget? How do you save money? Can you help me? And I'm no miracle worker. I promise you, I'm really not. But you're gonna get mad because you can't live the way you usually live. And when I tell y'all, you have to live within your means, I mean that. And you have to live by it. You have to swear by it. You have to abide by it. Like, you have to literally, like, count, like, all of your money. Period. Like, and if you're not, the one thing that, like, really, like, messes us up is the fact that we're swiping blindly. So when you're buying stuff, like, out of spur of the moment or as an impulse buyer, you're swiping blindly. You do not know how much money you have in your car, but you know, I got a little something, I can afford something to eat real quick, and you're swiping without seeing it. And that's the fault that we have when it comes to not carrying cash. So if you're just swiping, you need to stop, because the biggest, like, problem that we have nowadays is the fact that we swipe without knowing. So you need to carry cash. And I know cash is kind of like a horrible thing to have right now because of the coronavirus and, you know, other things of that sort, and the coin shortage and things like that. But you gotta have it visible. And if you don't do that, And you still are swiping, you need to make sure that you have your banking app or whatever you have that has your money on it you're gonna have to, after every single transaction, you're gonna have to account for it. Like, you're gonna have to literally look at your app every time you're about to buy something and then account for it and see if you can afford it. That's the way you gotta live. And for me, the way that I do it, I literally just don't even look at my bank account. Like, if I pay all my bills when they're supposed to be paid, and I count, like, I have a calendar, a dry erase calendar that I got from my sister. She bought it for me. I have that, and I literally write down, this is the day that I went out to eat, or this is the day that I'm cooking, this is what I'm going to be cooking for the rest of the week. You got to have a lot of dry erase boards and a lot of stuff to write stuff down with if you want to keep budgeting and live a better lifestyle. But the thing that's going to really get you is, you can't live the way you want to live. You can't go where you want to go. You can't shop just because other people are shopping. I haven't been able to live, like, buy myself clothes, buy myself shoes, anything for years. I haven't been able to buy anything for myself for like 3 years, and I haven't really bought anything for myself. If you do see anything new on me, it's because I stole it from my sister's closet, or I found some stuff for like $5 at Walmart or Rainbow or something like that. That's the only way that I literally have new stuff. Like, maybe there will be a sale, and I got some holiday pay like once or twice a year, and I'm like, okay, well, I can afford $40 for myself. And blind swiping is a curse. It is a curse. It is a habit, and you need rehab from it. So please stop doing that and find a visual way to account for your money, whether it's carrying cash or it's staying on your banking app so you are mindful of what you're spending. I come from a generation where we used to have checkbooks, and when you had a checkbook, you wrote down everything that you had to pay. You had your receipt, and you wrote down everything that you just spent. So girl, honey, man, sir, let's get to it. Okay, we're here. All right, you guys, I did go a little bit over budget with spending, but it's gonna be okay because I'm working overtime to make up for it. I got a lot, but this stuff should last me until almost the end of the month. I got, except for the fruits and stuff, and I got me a bottle here. I didn't just buy this, but I'm trying to do better with my water intake, so I got this bottle here. So fill this up twice. That's your water for the day. So I'm doing better with that. I usually try to split it up half this time and then half the next time. Like, I'll do 60, like spend 60 this one trip, and then in 2 weeks I'll spend 60 the next trip, so it'll be an even number. But this time I went 100, and so next time I can only re-up.
Okay, you guys, my mom helps me out with buying fruit and sometimes juices for Allie during the week, so I don't have to worry about that. But I got four of these Lunchables. She really likes these. They weren't on sale. They were like almost $2. I buy this type of spinach mix, and I have some chicken that goes inside of this, frozen chicken. I just get the Food Lion brand. It tastes just the same, and you get more out of it instead of paying like $8 for Tyson chicken. I got some strawberries for Allie and Dill. Allie's really been asking for these apples. I get them like this because she tends to waste the whole apple. I mean, she'll eat the whole apple, but those tend to go like that fast. I got yogurt that came in the pack. And Go-Gurt, because if you didn't notice on my coupons, it was buy both of these, get like $1 or $2 off, something like that. So I use my coupons for that. And what else? Freeze food. I forgot to get more Minute Maid. I really love Minute Maid, but I'm obsessed with orange juice. Orange juice over apple any day. That's my refrigerator telling me to close it. I got four of these. It was like buy five for $1, something like that. They were $1 piece. And I think that's, oh, I got more hash browns because we go through these like crazy. I got shrimp, and I also got mussels so me and Dale can have like a seafood thing. And yeah, I know you guys enjoy grocery hauls. If you guys couldn't tell, and when I was showing you guys the app, I was gonna save $26 when I went to the store. But however, I saved a whopping $23.18. It was going to be $121, but after all the discounts and stuff, it knocked it down to just $100 even. So that's really great savings. So if you guys want to shop with me again, let me know in the comment section down below. I love you guys, and be safe, be blessed, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Also, be sure to like this video and every other video that you like, and also be sure to turn your post notifications on because you do not want to miss a single video. I love you guys, be safe, be blessed, and I'll see you next time. Bye.
I'm a cold motherfucker though. 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 Keep a G, never love a hoe. Keep a skein in the underclothes. Whoa.